I get a lot of questions from growers and agents working with our different strawberry growers around the state about how do you detect whether a plant has been injured by a winter freeze. And so I thought I'd show you in a few seconds here how we go about doing that. First of all, you just need a little hand trowel like this and pick a warmer day in winter to do it. And just go around the base of the plant, around the periphery here, about the size of the plastic hole, and just go ahead and dig it up. And you should see some nice, healthy roots. And my gosh, this one must be a foot long. Pretty impressive root system for this plug plant. And then the next thing to do is go ahead and separate out the soil from the plant. The plug, this was a plug plant, so you can actually see some of the original artificial soil media that we use. Give it a good shake, and you begin to see the what I call the original plant. And that darker area is where the plug root ball was originally. You can see how nicely it's gone out beyond the plug and rooted through since last October. What we're going to do now is a quick check or diagnostic, if you will, for whether you've had any serious injury to the plant. And what it involves is just taking a knife, and you might want to have a piece of wood or a wood block like I have here to do this on. And what we do is usually what we first step is just go ahead and peel off all the leaves like this. It makes it a little bit easier to do the cut that I'm going to do next. And it's good to get as much of that soil off as you possibly can. And then finally, what I'm going to do is make what we call an up and down or longitudinal cut right through the crown tissue. And the objective is to take a look at the inside of the crown and see if we see a nice ivory white color. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. And I usually start from up at the top, and I'll cut right through some of those flower buds that have emerged from the crown this winter. I'm going to go right on through and try to make it so that we can get a good idea as to whether we've had some crown injury. And we've had some slight injury here, actually. I've learned that you've got to look very quickly. Once the air gets to this tissue, it begins to oxidize and it turns brown. But what I can tell you, this other night that got to 5 degrees, there's actually some injury here in these areas of light brown patches of tissue. That's from the cold event the other night. And I suspect if we cut into another plant that was under the row cover, we won't see evidence of any of these light brown patch areas. This is mild injury, though. This is not something I would be concerned about if I were a commercial grower. What I concern myself about when I make cuts like these is when I see large streaks of brownish tissue that runs up and through the crown area, which I don't see that here. Luckily, we came through, I think, in good shape, but no doubt there was some injury from that 5 degree exposure. I'd like to show you another plant and cut through its crown. And this plant is a plant that was beneath the row cover protection during a recent freeze episode of 5 degrees Fahrenheit. So let's go ahead and do the same thing again. We take the leaves off. Give it a good shake, get all that soil away from the roots. And then we're all set to go ahead and make that longitudinal cut through the crown again. We'll do that right now. And I go right from the center at the top of the plant in the crown area where I'm cutting through the crown first. I usually do it this way because it's a cleaner cut and you don't drag a lot of soil from the root into that nice white ivory tissue of the crown itself. And it looks excellent. I had a little red clay come in on my blade. But what I'd like to show you is a crown that looks very much in good condition. There's that ivory color. And as I show this to you, you'll begin to see some darkening. And that's as the air is exposed to this crown tissue, it does begin to darken. Now I'm going to make a second cut because this cut was actually a little bit too far out towards the edge. I'm going to take another look at this same crown here and bear with me. Okay, now I'm going to open it up and have a look. Oh, that's perfect. This is a great dissection of it, you can see what we call the cambium tissue. That's that different whitish colored tissue here that is critical to this plant's production of new cells and regenerating new plant tissues. If this area is darkened, you could be in a lot of trouble. But thankfully, that is all in good shape, and the center of the crown was a nice ivory color with no brown patching whatsoever. So it looks like that row cover did its job here the other night. And so this crop is as good as it was going into that freeze. It's come out pretty much unscathed.